It has been a common sight for the past year. Tens of thousands of members of the conservative Tea Party movement descend on Washington, upset with President Obama and Democrats in Congress. Julia McLeod attended a rally in August.
We're concerned what Congress is doing, what Obama's doing. We want less government. We don't want to be taxed.
Driving much of that conservative anger is frustration with the national economy, especially the weak job market, says Quinnipiac University pollster Peter Brown.
The economy is issues 1 through 129. And by the economy, most people mean unemployment. And until the unemployment rate gets markedly better, it's unlikely that voters will be any more optimistic about the economy, and therefore that will probably not be good for President Obama.
Republicans also expect to gain congressional seats because of concern over a growing budget deficit and the size of government, says expert John Fortier of the American Enterprise Institute.
Well, I think that the driving issue is that the opposition, Republicans and Tea Party people, don't like the direction the country's going in. They think the economy's bad, and they think that government is getting too big.
Among those leading the conservative charge is former Alaska Governor Sarah Palin. Palin is a favorite of Tea Party supporters and a possible presidential candidate 2 years from now.
We can't wait until 2012 to get our country back on the right track. We need to start now by electing strong leaders who aren't afraid to shake it up.
President Obama's poll ratings have dropped, but he remains the Democrats' best hope of keeping majorities in Congress as he campaigns around the country.
It's still fear versus hope, the past versus the future. It's still a choice between sliding backward and moving forward. That's what this election's about. That's the choice that you will face in November.
Experts agree that Republicans will make gains in November. Pollster Peter Brown says the only question is, how many?
Well, historically, the party that holds the White House loses seats in the off-year elections, and it would be a shock if the Democrats didn't lose seats this year. The question is how many they're going to lose. There are a lot of people who think this will be a very, very good Republican year.
And the results could have a huge impact on President Obama's governing style and his ability to get things done, says expert John Fortier.
I think whatever the outcome, whether Republicans take the House or whether they fall a little bit short, it will look very different for the next 2 years. It will be a time of either small accomplishments or of great conflict between the parties. There will be no time to work on other things on the big Obama legislative agenda.
Republicans need a gain of 39 seats to regain control of the House and 10 seats to win back a majority in the Senate. Jim Malone, VOA News, Washington.